I'm Nancy Creaghead, and I am on the faculty at the University of Cincinnati, and I have been there for 40 years. So over the last, 10 years, let's say, we've had a number of projects going on in Head Start, and our goals primarily are to collaborate with teachers and then to enhance the language and literacy education in the preschool classroom. You know, one of the issues it really is in working with the kinds of settings we have. We have a long-standing relationship with this Head Start program, and so we're able to go in there and we're able to be accepted, and we have our entree is good. But being able to be able to design the study and have it go the way you want to is not easy, because when you're working in real life settings, then there are many things that happen. And we've tried to do projects across the year. Some of them have been like 6 weeks or 8 weeks. We've had 6 month projects. And so some of the challenges are that the teachers may not stay. We've lost teachers when we're working in projects. The children may not stay. So when we're trying to do a project that's across a whole 6 month or even maybe 9 month time frame to really see change in what happens with children, then you have the challenge of, especially when you're working in areas where there's a lot of moving and children changing schools and changing centers, then challenges are to maintain those settings. IRBs are always hard too. That's the first challenge that you have to get is getting an IRB, which is of course more difficult when you're working with children, and also lots even more difficult when you're working in an outside setting. Another huge challenge is getting good recordings. So when you're working in with children around and in a setting where you don't have controlled sound environment and lots of noise. So that's one of the biggest challenges that we come back and say, oh my gosh, we don't have recordings, we can actually hear. Well, going back to advice about, first of all, starting out with more subjects than you need, that's for sure. And being sure that you have, that you do have a setting where you know you're going to get buy-in. I mean, when I say be sure, that's oversimplifying. I don't think you're ever sure that you're going to have total buy-in and it's going to work. In regard to the recordings, having children individually mic'd is just critical, and sometimes we have not done that from the very beginning of having a microphone in the setting of without individual mics is difficult. Having more and more, we're being able to use more sophisticated systems also within our own clinic for recording, and then for tracking those systems and tagging the information. So new technology things are coming on every day to make that easier. And another thing that's sometimes surprising to me is when, especially if you're in a setting and you're videotaping, or video recording. I've got to get this taping word out of my brain. Your video recording, or your recording period, and the amazing wealth of data that you get that you can use in so many ways, and that sometimes when you have this recorded data, what you studied over here, you may be able to study this other thing that's just incredible. You see things when you have that recording that, oh, we should look at this. That's exciting and surprising. Learning from teachers is, because my area is primarily schools, is huge. In another recent project where we were looking at reading comprehension in a classroom, and this was third, fourth, and fifth grade classrooms. And one of the things that we really learned in that setting from that teacher was what's really possible in that classroom. Because what we were trying to look at was faithfulness to the intervention. And what kind of difference that made once the intervention was put in place. And then we had a single subject design to look at faithfulness and faith to it. And we had to make a lot of changes in there to say, you can't be that faithful. I mean, this is what you have to do to be real in that setting. And I think that's really what you learn from being in those settings. And to me, it's so hard, and it's so messy. It's so incredibly messy, but it's just not real if we aren't in there, in the real setting where it really happens. Not that we don't have to also have that background research to say, well, let's try this and let's see if it works here. But to me, the exciting part is really trying to see how it plays out in those real settings. The interest for working for doing authentic research and doing research that is related to the environment and takes into account the environment, that new interest is really exciting to me, because it's going to help us make changes in the real world, and in the real world where, in my case, children go to school, or where people are actually treated in hospitals, or and where the team is a part of what's going on. And the fact that implementation science is really something that is coming to the forefront, that to me is real. I guess that's really the most exciting thing, is to actually hear people talking about implementation research and implementation science, and raising the bar, increasing the amount and raising the bar, and having a commitment to implementation research.